Press Z, then B to breakdance kick. Press Z, then B to breakdance kick. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough. I've been meaning to show that move for a while, but I kept forgetting to do so. Anyway, we're about to go into why this world is one of the more annoying worlds in the game, starting with Stand Tall on the Four Pillars. It is exactly what it says it is. We've got to get to the top of all four of the pillars in this level, and probably the easiest way to do it is to fly to them, because two of them are in really treacherous positions, and I prefer not to take too many unnecessary risks. So yeah, let's go. Okay, when you're on one of the pillars, it doesn't really show you it doesn't tell if you've triggered anything in particular. You've just gotta trust that you did trigger something, if that makes sense. You just gotta stand on top of all four pillars, even though no red numbers or any indication that you did something good appeared there. So yeah, so that's three, and let's go over to the last one. And once you reach the last one, switch camera over to the pyramid. The top flies off and explodes. underneath it is a hole. And this takes you over to the multicolored central pillar that you might have seen when you were in this pyramid before. Where is it around here? I don't know where. Oh, there it is. This right here. You might have noticed that there was an inaccessible hole here before. Speedrunners probably can get in this hole without that elevator, but this is the regular way to do it. Anyway, down here is a boss known as I-Rock! Who walk here? Who break seal? Wake, ancient ones! We know like light. We know like intruders. Now battle! Hand to hand! It sounds just like Big Womp, by the way. The objective is to punch its eyes out, just like that, and don't let it push you off the edge. Be careful of that. Boop. Aha! And you'll be able to tell when it takes damage because it makes that sound. Just gotta do it when its palm and eyeball is open. Wait, I'm not sure if that one counted. Maybe they're counting. That's because one's already down. It's a really easy boss. Just be careful not to let it push you off the edge. It's already over.
What happened? We crushed like pebble. You so strong. You rule ancient pyramid for today. Now take Star of Power. We sleep. Darkness.
It seems kind of vengeful because it says, you know, for today I won, but at the same time it's going to sleep. I don't know, but there's your star. Don't question the ancient ones. Alright, let's see what's up next, and I found 70 power stars! The mystery of the endless stairs is solved, thanks to you. And Bowser is ever upset. Now, on to the final bout! I was already up there, I already cheated my way up there with the glitch, so I don't need your stinking unlocking. Anyway, free flying for 8 red coins. If I recall correctly, there are eight red coins, but there are 4 on the ground and 4 in the air, if I'm remembering correctly. One of them is in this very precarious place. It's really hard to tell if you're touching the slope. You do not want to touch the slope. You see that slope there? Yeah, it's very hard to tell because of the game's perspective and the way textures work, so it's, yeah. I'm just gonna take a little exploration route around here. If you want that one up, you gotta use the shell to get it, or do a really tricky long jump. Did I see a coin under here before? I think, yeah, okay, there's 2 there. Number 2 there, I should say. I'm gonna have to fly to get the other 4 in the air. I think there's one over by, well, at least one over by the quicksand blocky area here, the tox box area. And, oh no, it's not over here. Where is? Oh, there it is. I thought it was further in the corner, but I was wrong. There's 3. looking for number four, wherever that might be. I don't recall. Oh, it's in the oasis. The, this pool over here. I didn't really show this pool, did I? Oh, no, wait, it's not. Oh, there, yeah, it is in the oasis. Oh, and as long as I'm here, I should probably show you what it's like when Mario doesn't have a hat. So, would you mind taking my hat, or is that impossible when I've got the wing cap? How do I get rid of my wing cap? I forgot how to do that, like, on command. Ah, well, it's going away. So here, take my cap, please, Klepto. There we go. And now Mario is capless. While you are capless, you will take double damage, so you do not want to be capless. I just wanted to show you that that is a possibility in this game. And if you somehow cannot, I mean, if you somehow lose your cap, then die or something like that, what will happen is you will find the cap in the same world that you lost it in via some enemy. So yeah, just keep that in mind. So anyway, I got four of the coins now. The rest are in the air, and I'm probably going to have to use some of these twisters to make things a little bit easier. So, come on, over here. Help me up. Nope, closer to that. There we go. Ah, I'm not high enough for that one. Dang it. I wonder if I should just fly to each of the coins. I mean, they do want me to fly, but flying is kind of risky, in all honesty. Stay away now, Tornado. I don't want your help. I don't need your kind of help. All I want is this hat, so I can get on top of a pillar again. And, oh, I could have got that coin from that height, couldn't I have? Oh, poopers. No, wait, let me, thank you. One, two, three. There we go. I wonder if I could get all the red coins from, just like from the pillars. Yeah, I think I can get them from the pillars. That certainly will make my job a lot easier. I'm gonna replenish my cap though by going up here. And I didn't want to fly that far. I wanted to skid on the ground. Thank you. There we go. Cap replenished. And let's go over to the next pillar, which is right here. I gotta get some speed by dipping down. Yeah. Well, it's not on the next pillar, but it's easiest to get from the pillars. Seven. And I'm not going to be able to get that unless I go back on the pillar, aren't I? Nope, I didn't think so. Oh, pain, pain, pain. Okay, I'm good. I'm good. Everything's working out. And there's the eighth coin. I'm going to go back over there before my cap runs out, hopefully. There we go. Yeah, much, much easier to get those if you use the wing cap instead of the tornadoes. And there we go. Yeah! Another one bites the sand. Up to 71. I wonder if I should do the 100 coin star this part, because that's going to take me a while. Oh, pyramid puzzle. This one's also going to take me a while. Maybe I won't have time to do the 100 coin part in this part. Well, technically I have unlimited upload time, so I have all the time that I need, but, you know, I don't want to make parts too long, because that'll turn people away who don't have enough time to do so. So, yeah, I try to keep my parts around a stable, fair length, basically, so I don't impede people's viewing time. Alright, so back in the pyramid, we are going to be getting some very special coins in this area. I believe they are all in that sandy coin chute, like the sand falls, if I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong, though. But anyway, I'm going to be starting from the top and working my way back down. But I did that jump before, why can't I do it now? Maybe because I didn't have enough speed this time. You've seen me do that jump before, come on now. Oh, by the way, this quicksand is not very dangerous whatsoever, as you can tell. I mean, it seems like it could be, but it's not really. Alright, I'll just take the normal way that they want me to take. You're supposed to go around this way, actually. You're supposed to go around it counterclockwise. I didn't really show this side anyway, but this isn't at all important to any other star. Well, I could actually shortcut on the mummified thwomp, of which I still don't know the name of offhand. Because what I'm looking for here is, remember those sand pathways like this right here? Well, there's a couple of them that lead to special coins. You have to touch those coins in order to find the red spots in order to make a star appear somewhere. And like you see that coin at that corner of that sand? Well, that's one of the red spots, I think. Now, I'll show you right now. See that? I got a red number from that, but there's coins in higher locations, which is why I want to start at a high spot and then work my way down. It's just to make things a little bit easier. So there we go. I could, you know, go against the flow of sand if I wanted to, but that would just take forever. I'm way too impatient for that. Nope, nope, don't you dare wall kick. Don't wall kick unless... Mario! Wall kick only when I tell you to wall kick. Alright, no amp. You're not getting the better of me. Wait, did I go too high? I might have gotten... I think I'm too high. Oh, shoot! Surprisingly, that sand is a lot more firm than it appears. Okay, yeah, I'm definitely too low now. But I mean, I think I was too high before. Okay, maybe I will just take out the complications and just go against the flow of sand. Because at least I know I'm on the right path there, but I think I'm actually supposed to jump down on it for a couple of reasons, because I can't actually jump up to the coins I need to jump up to. And that's why I wanted to start from the top then to the bottom, yeah. Because otherwise I'd be fighting with this the whole way, but I think this is better than my other method. I clearly had no idea where I was going. It's too... let me around. Stop it. Stop it. Go. Go. Yeah, see? There, I was supposed to drop down onto this from something above, and I didn't do that. And yes, the sand does make you sink a little bit, by the way. Just thought I would put that out there. Yeah. I guess you don't need to use that fence whatsoever to get up there. Alright, so what did I miss when I came through here? The first time. What am I forgetting? Probably a lot of things, knowing my memory. So let's go into first person view and... oh, maybe I was supposed to go even higher. Maybe. Because there's a limit to how high you can go. Yeah, maybe I didn't go high enough last time. Sorry for thinking out loud here and not coming up with clever commentary of sorts, but I'm puzzled. Oh yeah, there they are. Okay, I didn't go high enough for sure. Alright, Mummy Thwomp. I'm going under you. Whether you like it or not. Nope, nope. Okay, now I gotta drop down onto these coins carefully, very carefully. Where is the next? Can I just like carefully? I want to see ledges. Oh, okay, that was not friendly. Didn't I tell you this world is annoying? There's a lot of this in it. It's a lot of climbing back up due to the slightest mistakes. No, don't squish me, please. Thank you. You know what? I'm too impatient for your shenanigans. I'm too impatient for you guys. I'm too impatient for everything. Just let me up here. Let me get those coins and get out of here, because this part gotta end eventually. And yeah, I'm definitely not gonna have enough time for the 100 coin stars here.
So, okay.
How do I want to jump down for those coins? Like, what should I be aiming for when I jump down for those things? They seem to be on the left and right of that sandfall, but not directly, not directly under it. So I guess that's where I should be aiming my jumps, per se. Don't squish me. All right, let's give this another shot. Just gotta carefully drop down. All right, now for here. I want to, the camera's gonna kill me, isn't it? I want to go like here. Okay, and then just before I drop down, just to make sure perspective worked for me. Okay, it is directly to the side of me, so that means I can like do this. Yes, there we go. And see, when you start from the top and go down, then you're supposed to follow the sandfalls over to that star. Like, you would take those three coins first, and then you would follow the sand chute all the way over to that star. And that's what I thought I was going to be able to do, but I didn't go up high enough the first time. Yeah, whatever. Anyway, there is your star. If I can get carefully without falling, there we go. And with that, I'm gonna end off the part here. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next part.